Even the pores on her skin, she looks... Is she soft or is she hard?
My name is Erica. It's a pleasure to meet you. Would you like to hear a little about me?
Japan just delivered fully performing female robots. Japan continues its rise to status as a world-leading startup and technology ecosystem. Investment has continued to flow into Japan's tech scene. In 2016, venture companies in Japan focused on three key areas. Robotics rose 329%, artificial intelligence, or AI, rose 246%, and the Internet of Things rose 184% over the year before. This is alongside Prime Minister Shinzo Abe's goal to create 20 unicorn startups by 2023, brings us many new robotic innovations. Let's take a look at the latest innovations from Japan in the robotic sphere. Robot to tackle Fukushima debris. US-based Jacobs has designed and built a robotic tool to obtain crucial information about the state of a damaged nuclear power reactor at Fukushima Daiichi in Japan. The remotely operated device will collect pebble-like debris that was deposited at the bottom of the reactor containment vessel after the meltdown caused by the earthquake and tsunami in March 2011. A prototype of the device has passed extremely demanding factory acceptance and performance tests to meet the requirements of Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, or MHI, which is leading the development project. It is expected that, following selection in Japan, a radiation-resistant version will be built that will be able to carry out the important task of retrieving samples from the highly contaminated reactor. This is a prime example of how we are combining innovative engineering and deep nuclear knowledge to help decommissioning agencies meet the challenge of transforming legacy sites into a safe end state, said Jacobs Energy Security and Technology Senior Vice President Karen Vemelt. The exact nature of the debris is currently unknown, and examination of the retrieved debris samples will provide crucial data for the next steps in the cleanup and decommissioning of the Fukushima reactors. The robotic tool was designed by Jacobs' engineers in the UK and had to meet more than 300 functional, operational, performance, and geometric requirements. It also had to be small enough to enter the damaged containment vessel and pick up sand and pebbles up to 10 millimeters in size by deploying a bucket-style retrieval device. Fanuc showcases superior robot technology. World production industry, which is accelerating the shift to full automation of factories, requires precise control technology to make robots work to complete its mission. Fanuc is the first Japanese company to develop a numerical control device. The development and control technology of motor and servo support factories working around the world. Until now, some companies are familiar with robots, and some customers are setting robots for the first time. Recently, the demand ratio of customers who want to use new robot technology has been increasing. As a premise, there is the recognition that robot technology would be difficult to use without specialized technology. But this time, I would like to tell you that there are robots that can be easily installed and moved, said Kiyonori Inaba, an official of Fanuc. The concept of Fanuc's latest robot is that of a collaborative one. The technology to ensure safety is equipped. The robot stopped instantly when it contacts me. The sensor detects that a person contacted the robot, added Kiyonori. The introduction of the collective robot is attracting attention as a collaboration production system between human beings and robots as a step toward to full autonomous factory. Sunken tour boat successfully raised to surface. A salvage firm has successfully raised a sunken tour boat to the sea surface off the Shiretoko Peninsula in Japan's northern prefecture of Hokkaido. The Kazu 1 sightseeing boat sank on April 23 off the peninsula with 26 people on board. 14 have been confirmed dead with their bodies recovered, and 12 others remain unaccounted for. The salvage firm, in its first attempt, lifted the boat from the seabed at a depth of 120 meters to near the surface. But the boat sank again to the seabed off Utoro Port in the town of Shadi, while it was being towed by a barge. The vessel was later confirmed to be lying on the seabed at a depth of about 180 meters. In the next attempt, the salvage firm had used an undersea robot to put belts on the boat. With that, the firm began pulling the vessel up toward the surface. The boat surfaced from the water after 6:50 p.m. Then, the vessel was fixed to the barge with ropes around 7:10 p.m. The salvage firm is going to tow the boat to shallow waters and lift it onto the barge. The boat is expected to be unloaded at nearby Abashiri port. Epson to unveil new scara robots at Automate 2022. As the automation industry continues to grow, manufacturers are seeking robot solutions that offer the highest levels of performance. To meet the need for high-end automation, Epson will debut their new high-power-density scara robots, which deliver next-level performance and flexibility. Automate attendees will have the opportunity to experience live product demonstrations of these new scara robots, in addition to product introductions and overviews of their six-axis robots, integrated vision guide and IntelliFlex parts feeding systems, and ColorWorks label printer. Epson Robots previously announced updates to its T-Series line with the T3B and T6B all-in-one scara robots. The T3B and T6B scara robots offer high quality and high performance to simplify both complex and simple automation applications, such as packaging, pick and place, dispensing, and inspection. These all-in-one industrial robots include the same software, features, and reliability found in Epson's high-end robots, while keeping total cost of ownership low in industries spanning automotive, medical development, lab automation, consumer electronics, electronic components, and industrial. Epson strives to simplify automation for all users, and the new T3B and T6B are designed to provide uncomplicated solutions with productive outcomes, said Scott Marsick, Group Product Manager at Epson. Paired with the no-code Epson RC Plus Express software, users can add the robots to automation systems in no time. The Mini Lunar Explorer. This mini, hand-sized sphere is not your ordinary toy. It's an exploration robot called Sora-Q that was jointly developed by major Japanese toy maker Tomy and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency to send to the moon. The robot, measuring only 250 grams and 8 centimeters in diameter, has two wheels at the side which can move on powdery sand and has two cameras, in the front and rear, that can take pictures and transmit images back to Earth. It's also made from a special type of aluminum and plastic that can withstand the harsh temperature difference on the moon, which, according to JAXA, can go anywhere between negative 170 degrees to 110 degrees Celsius. Tomy Company employee and Sora-Q developer Kenta Hashiba said their experience and techniques to produce children's toys helped the creation of this robot. It transforms from a sphere to another shape. Also, it is very small and light in size. The techniques to make smaller toys, simple crafted toys, and the techniques for a toy to move are all implemented, he said. He added that he would be happy if children were to develop an interest in space by watching the robot go up into space. JAXA is planning to send the robot on its lunar lander SLIM, or Smart Lander for Investigating Moon, in fiscal 2023. It will take pictures of the moon and the landing of SLIM, which researchers hope will develop their space exploration. Android face to test your emotional intelligence. Researchers from the Riken Guardian Robot Project in Japan say they've created an Android child, which they've named Nicola, that is capable of successfully conveying six basic emotions. It's the first time the quality of Android-expressed emotions has been tested and confirmed in these emotions. Nicola's face contains 29 pneumatic actuators that control a network of artificial muscles, allowing it to approximate the twists and tugs of the 43 or so real muscles in the human face. Another six actuators move the head and eyeballs. Movement is powered by air pressure, keeping the motion smooth and silent, more like a human, less like a clanking machine. But most crucially, Nicola was trained to mimic expressions using past research on distinctive quirks, characteristics of particular emotions. A raise of the eyebrow, a stretch of the cheek, a drop of the jaw, a curl of the mouth, for example. That's all for this video, folks. See you another time.